through mind control. So take a look at this clip from John Todd, and if you're not familiar with it, this is a good time to understand this stuff about music. And if you've heard it before, I definitely recommend you listen to it again. And oh, and keep a listen out for him talking about David Crosby, because David Crosby is mentioned in this. He was a friend of David Crosby's at the time because he was a high-ranking warlock in the occult. And David Crosby was as well in the music industry. So these people are all connected and they're all friendly with each other, no matter what their position is, because this guy could just be a regular grocery store employee. You wouldn't know the difference because they're all over the place. We just don't see them. But take a listen and listen out for that as well.
You may not be in witchcraft. You may not think that this message has anything to do with you, but you're missing the whole point. I was in a world where it was impossible to become a Christian, and Jesus made me one. I was by one of the girls I used to live with when I was in the occult world. Recently, she was at a very important witchcraft meeting that we happened to find out about, and I pulled into the parking lot for a few minutes to see who was there. And she walked by the car. I had a couple Christian brothers with me. She looked in the car and just smiled and kept on walking, never recognized me. That's the difference between the way I am now the way I was then. When the Lord changes you, he totally changes you. Now, we give our testimony for several reasons, to show that no matter what, whether you were raised a Christian and you know, all your life, or you were raised in the worst frame of life, it's still the same miracle. God still saves you just the same. Sometimes I think it's harder to get the PKs and the Christian kids saved than it is the witches. But at the same time, we try to flag you down from going the same direction we went, with drugs. You'll never know the feeling to lose so many friends that should be with you today and so many loved ones because of drugs that we kept convincing ourselves was all right. This isn't some preacher getting up here and telling you that's never been in it. I wished I had a half hour to talk about the worst thing that the occult world ever planned out and carried out. That's called rock music. But I'm going to say two quick things. Parents, the rock music does not belong to you, your kids. If your kids are in your home, it belongs to you and you're answerable for it. And if you want to believe they're garbage, that it's all right, and you want to forget things like Kiss saying that their real name is Kings and Satanic Service, and that rock music is actually satanic spells being cast and being planned by the Satanist Church, and that's a direct quote, then you go right on ahead. Right now, one of the Manson family girls is in trial, and she said the number one thing that the occult world used to brainwash them was Beatle music and rock music. If you want to leave it in your home, I won't go into details why you can't, but if you want to leave it in your home and all the demons that it attracts, fine. If you want your kids to buffalo you, then it's all right. But I recommend you go home today, get a cardboard box, and break the records, and burn those covers, and get it out of your home. And you'd be surprised at how fast your kids come around after they finish throwing their two-year-old tantrum. But I wish that I had the time more on rock music, but believe me, it is the work carefully planned out in the occult world. We spent $8 million to produce Jesus rock music and paid the man who started it named Chuck Smith just because Christians were destroying rock music and we were afraid that it would be banned from the Christian church. So we carefully put it in the form of Christian rock music. So if they would spend $8 million to keep rock music in your hands, then the hardcore rock must be even worse. And it is. I'm going to... Okay, Pastor. I don't mind. I drove all day so I could say these things. I was the manager of Zodiac Productions, which Zodiac Productions name's been changed since then. I'm not even sure what to call it now, but it's the largest music conglomerate in the world. It owns RCA Records, Columbia Records, Motown Records, owns almost all the concert booking agencies in the United States. And that's not even the name of the company that owns it. The name of the company that owns it is Brenner Enterprises. And Brenner Enterprises is owned by Chase Manhattan. Chase Manhattan's owned by Standard Oil, and Standard Oil's owned by the Lords of London. You can track it all back. You kind of get the idea after a while. But I was the managing president of Zodiac Productions. It's one of my jobs, being one of these 13 people. Thus, I got to know many of the people who produce music and sing the music and play the music that you play. Recently, one of the top people in rock music from the group, I can't think of the name of the group now, it's one of the top rock groups still in existence. That's been around a long time, was just saved. And he told how when they'd play in their concerts, they would control through witchcraft spells in their mind the people to do different things and they'd work the audience up not with their music, but with their mind and their music combination. Now, one of the closest friends that I got during that time that I attained, a man named David Crosby, Crosby Stills Nash & Young. I saw David the day before Christmas last year, talked with him. I got him away from this witch that he had with him. He told her to go shopping. We were in West Hollywood, and I was witnessing around to people I knew. We went off in this store, and we started talking. I said, David, I'd like to ask you a couple questions. I said, I already know the answers, but I've been gone for 5 years. I'd like to know if certain things are still the way they were when I left. I said, I'll have to explain some of this when I'm done. She's not going to understand it all unless you know something about music. I said, do they still take the master to the temple room? Dave said, yeah. I said, do they still have the coven conjure demons into the master?
The new five-amp
master. He said, of course. I said, now, I got to know something. What's the main reason for rock music? Come on, Lance, you know what the reason is. Please, David, I don't want to guess. Tell me what the main reason is. He said, the same as when you were in, so that we can play spells on people that we couldn't cast spells upon. I'll explain what that means in a minute. I said, okay, one last thing. I've been hearing that you must be an initiated witch now to get a record contract. He said, that's right. He said, many of us that weren't total witches have to be witches now in order to produce music. Thank you. The master is a tape about as big as the top of this podium. It looks like an overgrown 8-track that the album is cut on and is placed in a machine that produces and presses the records and the 8-tracks and cassettes that you buy. After it's been recorded, it's taken in. This is why a master's cut months in advance before it's released. On the full moon, it's taken in to a temple room about the size of this auditorium that is in every one of the major music companies. Beyond locked doors up in the executive office. And it's placed on an altar sitting in the north of the room and a pentagram engraved in the floor. And 13 hand-chosen witches and wizards and a coven come in and conjure a principality or a power up, usually regent or something like that, and order him to tell the demons under him to follow every record and every tape coming off of that master. If I tell many Christian parents, you can go home and count your kids' records, probably yours too, and count how many demons at least are there. That's too hard for you to believe? I'm sorry. That's why they do it. Now listen to me. This is why rock music is addicting. Have you ever seen kids that got rid of their music? They go around like this. They can't wait to find a rock station somewhere and they sneak off just like getting a cigarette or a fix because it's addicting. That's why they can't give it up. The rest of the conversation was this. You can't cast a spell on a Christian, but you can get a Christian to cast a spell on themselves. If you give the permission for the spell to work, being a Christian won't block it. And rock music is not just a song. It is supernatural music that which is carefully designed by their spirit guides, the familiar spirits, in the form of spells. Now, although the devil's music par is the music and God's music is the word, much of the songs are written in what we call witch language. Give you kind of an idea. You talk, many of you talk on the CB, unless you know what a smoky is, and a 10-4, and a front door, back door, rocking chair, and these type of things, you don't know what you're talking about. Same with witches. When you're in the first and second level, you have to learn over 2,000 words that said by anybody else means something totally different than when you say them. Elton John has said he's never written a song or sung a song that wasn't in witch language. And I want to show you something. See how many kids in here are beyond and adults. How many remember and have heard at least several times a song called Hotel California? Somebody tell me what it meant. Quickly, somebody tell me what it meant. Huh? That's pretty close. But from the words, what did it mean? Well, that's more of a guess. See, most people can't tell you. That's why when people do drugs and they listen to songs in which language, they get some of the meaning. But most of the time, they can't tell you. Stop and think how many songs are out there that you really like and you don't have any idea what the person was talking about. Beyond the Yellow Brick Road? How about The Destroyer by Kiss? Can anybody tell me what it's about? Kiss said in it, kids, tell your parents. They're talking about Helter Skelter. Beatles sung Helter Skelter in which language nobody knew what it meant. Manson did because he belonged to the process. Helter Skelter is a several thousand-year-old word. And they're believing that it's going to happen in a year from now, from this very date. Most of the music is either about Helter Skelter or a place called the Night Winds, which is what Hotel California is about, and different doctrines of witchcraft. You listen to them, your parents let you listen to them, and they have no idea. Kids openly brag how they were gaining
control of people through their music because the people played their music. They told how they didn't form their own group. Their church, because they were ordained ministers of the Satanist church, placed them together. And that's how most of the music is done. David Crosby, when him and Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young produced the record 2-Way Street, they ordered the principality of Medea to order demons of rebellion to go into the record, and everybody that heard it would be rebellious against law and order and government. And it was one of the reasons for the great upheaval in the 60s with that one album, and they take open credit for it. I can go on all night, but that's mainly it. Parents, get this stuff in and destroy it now. I guarantee your kids will straighten up. They may pout for a while, but they'll straighten up. Okay? Sorry, it's so late.
All right. We've been live action here with a bunch of mad owls now. This ain't nothing. how many of you believe he knows what he talks about when he talks about rock music? Huh?
Not enough of the kids, I'd probably say.
Yeah. Well, I sincerely believe he knows exactly what he's talking about there. And I hope you'll listen to it. I hope you'll hear where he's coming from. And if you continue listening to that junk, where you're going, we just cannot tolerate it as Christian people in our homes. You can't stop it from being played and sold all that, but we can't tolerate it. You mentioned, time or two, the Illuminati. Could you, in just a few words, summarize what you understand the Illuminati is?
Okay. Many people call it the Great Conspiracy, which is kind of true, but actually the Illuminati is about 1,000 conspiracies all running at one time. Therefore, a lot of them backfire. But it was formed about 100 years before its original birth date. The birth date is May 1st, 1776, which is always start everything on May 1st. That's why even the communist birthday is on May 1st. That's their New Year's Day. But it means the holders of the light, or the light bearers. Now, witches have another name for it, too. Since it is a death penalty to use the name of the Illuminati, you must say Mariah, which means the conquering, destroying wind. But its belief is that Lucifer, the conquering, destroying wind. But its belief is that Lucifer is God, and that everything else is imposter, and that Lucifer can bring peace to the world by his lifters or upholders' conspiracies. And they're going to conspire and conspire and conspire until they have a world government. Sometimes I wonder why they could be so dumb that they're doing exactly what is going to lead to their destruction. But then that's usually how the devil is. He keeps everything in darkness. But that's the Illuminati. It's a world conspiracy, and I might add, an extremely powerful one. The occult is its religion. Now, many of you are doctors, lawyers, mechanics, construction workers, businessmen, whatever. Most of you are Christians and Baptists. Okay? But he's your minister, or at least if you're from this church. And the Illuminati, they all have jobs. But the witches are their ministers. But they're all Luciferian. The witches are the ministers, and they're the church members, and the religion is Luciferianism. Now, the real Illuminati, the organization itself, is financially powerful and politically motivated. Through their finance, they have an old witch's room, which is kind of a saying, a poem. They say that the kings be kings, let the bankers be bankers, and let the priests be priests. Translated, it simply means that it doesn't matter who rules, as long as the bankers have the money, they'll own the person who rules. And the priests will run the bankers. That's the Illuminati.
You mentioned, John, some publication, you said it might be out in about 3 months. What is that again?
It's called Riot and Revolution. It's by Tom Berry, classmate of my pastor, Roland Rasmussen, graduate from Bob Jones, the Doctrine of Divinity, and it takes the plan of the Illuminati for Helter Skelter and gaining control of the world. It takes some of my testimony to justify it, and then it gives an answer to Christians what to do during Helter Skelter.
Now, where did the material come from, and how did you get it?
Some of it came from me, and some of it came from another minister named Joe Boyd. Some of it came from Jack Howe. He's gathered. Also, he had about 20 pages of notes when I met him, which he said he gained by going through about 2,000 books. We're on the Illuminati and the Bilderbergers. Okay?
Yeah.
Satan worshipers believe in Satan, which is the lower three levels believe in God or else God's self in ESP and so on. They believe in plural gods like the mother goddess Isis and so on. Or the higher levels are Luciferians, which believe in one god and the minor gods being in the Rothschild. Okay? That's the difference.
You mean the average witch is not taught that there is such a being as Lucifer or the devil?
Well, for one, when you believe in Lucifer, you don't believe in the devil. Okay? No, they believe in the mother goddess, which is called by many names, as the poem about her goes. Diana, Isis, Asherah, which was the female side of Baal. And they believe, actually, it's Baal worship. There was a male and female god. Asherah, and then the horned hunter of the night is the way he's portrayed in all countries, which is more or less kind of the underworld god, the devil, or whatever.
Anybody with a question or two before we're going to take a level off in here?
There's no difference.
What was his question?
The difference between rock music and soul music. There's no difference. Okay.
All right, some other questions.
In the back. They didn't come up with it. That was about a hurricane, somebody named Mariah, okay? Yeah. Yeah. And the Satanist church, Christ and Jesus are the same person, okay? No, that's the teaching. In the Satanist church, Christ, Jesus Christ, and Satan are the same person. That's the Satanist belief. And the Luciferians, they believe that Jesus Christ is the God of evil, okay? Like we would feel about the devil, they feel about Jesus. And Lucifer, they feel towards him like we feel about Jesus. That's what they teach, okay?
Okay. I don't know what he said, but it must have been good.
Well, a pastor didn't leave me. A Christian worker led me to the Lord. The person that helped rehabilitate me was Jack Taylor, but he wasn't around much because he was a pastor. He had to run around the country speaking. It was actually his music director and the youth director. Ann Rowitz was the youth director, and the music director was Malcolm Granger. And I stayed with Malcolm, and him and his wife worked with me, and the youth director worked with me quite a bit. But I don't envy him. I step back now. I guess I kind of blocked my mind out how bad I was. But watching all these kids go through rehabilitation, man, that was no easy job. They had to be on their knees a lot, I'll tell you. Black Sabbath. Come up, music group or a Black Sabbath? Well, the music group got its name from it. A Black Sabbath is a witch's Sabbath, okay? It comes 8 times a year. Beltane, right, you get the first part, Beltane is their New Year's Day. That was May 1st, okay? Halloween is Shaham. That was also one of theirs. There's 8 of them, okay? And they come around the year, and it's more or less their big party day, their super, super day. Now, if they're in the human sacrifice, they also do human sacrifice at the time. But it's a big time to have an orgy and a big drug party and this type of thing, everybody wiped out. That's the witch's Sabbath.
No?
Well, not the Satanist church, but the witchcraft church is. A very, very powerful witch has a song out about witchcraft now called The Force. His name is Tom T. Hall. I just heard very sick song recently, somebody let me hear. It was by Tammy Wynette, and it was talking about very sick song recently, somebody let me hear. It was by Tammy Wynette, and it was talking about Jesus Christ appearing on Midnight Special or something like Saturday Night something. Anyway, I'm afraid that if he appeared on that rock show, he'd probably bring the Cat of Nine Tails along with him. But there are some of the music. If it wasn't for witchcraft being behind rock music, I'd hate the country the most. Because I don't see how Christians can listen to it when it's talking about adultery, fornication, getting drunk, cutting people up, running around with everybody else's wife, and things like this. And that's all I ever hear on it. Okay?
Well,
Well, that's what they were referring to. Yeah, they did. No, I'm not going to tell you. Okay?
I believe Vic named Russ.
Human sacrifice? That's pretty...
On the occasion.
Oh, well, the occasion was on a Sabbath, okay? That particular Sabbath happened to be February the 2nd, Candlemas, okay? What was the rest of it? Well, it's done... That particular one was done because of an initiation ceremony that was being done. Mine. But most of the covens just practice 8 times a year if they're in the blood sacrifice. The lower witches believe that the power for witchcraft comes from orgies and sex. The higher witches believe it's obtained by human blood. Okay?
Russ, how many of you had your hand?
The revolution that they have planned within the United States. Most people feel that something like that will never happen in the United States. They're lying to themselves. It will happen. And it's not very far off. Well, by 1980, there'll be... Helter Skelter's only an excuse. Okay? The excuse is to be able to declare martial law. That's the whole reason for it. They promised the one side that they will be able to gain control of the United States through revolution, when the whole time is they're just simply setting them up to be able to declare martial law within the Constitution. and by 1980 they plan on being under martial law. I'm not saying, don't all of you start lynching me at one time. I didn't say it was going to happen. I said, this is their plan, okay? I'll leave it up to your own prayer life and watching the newspapers whether it's going to happen or not.
Maxine.
Just like most other cults. See, Jesus Christ requires just one way, only one way. The devil will use any way to keep your eyes off that one way, okay? And he uses the same tactics wherever it branches to. I have no idea if he came out after I got out. I have no idea. They were back in groups like him before, the Krishners and so on. I can't see much difference between them and those two groups. So they're probably back him too.
Okay, Mike and Bob.
Yeah, the Council of Foreign Relations. Now, and it's inner brainchild that runs this. It's called the Trilateral Commission. Okay?
Sally, Bob, and then Barbara.
Yeah, there's seven principalities, about 200 powers. Then it starts getting down into lower people we never pay attention to, the lower spirit.
Mother?
Yeah, I don't know, just recently, about 3 weeks ago in April, the day before Jack Howell came to our church to speak, and the day after he left, I came walking out of the church at Faith Baptist. One time I got in my car, started to drive off in the parking lot, about 30 people were standing around, and a passing car opened up on us with a gun. And then, that was Sunday night, then Wednesday night of that week, I was walking out into the parking lot prior to the church letting out with a couple of brothers. And when we dug the bullets out of where they hit, they had fired twice at us, and the bullets were 44 caliber, 44 magnum. So they don't play around. And the range was so close, it was from the back of that wall to here. You know that the Lord is in it. It really makes you appreciate his divine protection, let me tell you.
Bruce?
That world takeover plan ended with World War III. But one of the teachings is that when Lucifer sets up his kingdom, okay, that through World War III, most of the civilized world as it exists now will be in rubble. The one protected capital that they have purposely kept all missiles away from both sides, is Jerusalem. And they plan on using Jerusalem to set up from there, okay? Do they believe that Adam's original home, or the Garden of Eden, rests where Jerusalem is? So, gonna rule from there.
Mike and then Robin, we better let that maybe very quick.
The church that I attend, a member of, is Faith Baptist in Canoga Park, Dr. Rasmussen. The work where it's at, the house, has got to remain a silent. Okay, very well. All of our church walk around, people trying to find out where it's at, and everybody's shh. It's like the unspeakable secret. Okay? Everybody knows, but nobody says. He was a member of the Process Church of the Final Judgment, which in California is called Universal Church Triumphant Summit International. They always like these names.
Okay, let's see. Randy?
Not anymore. I try to keep out of communication as much as possible with them. My foster mother has a huge contract on my life, and my brother's trying to collect it, so I try to stay away from him.
By the way, Randy, you cannot communicate with them. You communicate with demons. They imitate them. I cannot speak to you. Just see, yes, brother.
All I can, you mean, in counting all the Sabbath day last year, from May 1st to May 1st, probably 500, and that's only a guess. I'm probably way under.
Dwayne has one of his books, Chick Publication, I believe it is, and they made up like a comic book. It tells you, here's
Broken Cross. That's the one I wrote.
This is the one that tells you one of the main methods of how they get victims to offer up and go and sacrifice. All right, Robin, I think we better let this be it.
Okay, give me about a minute on this here.
Okay,
you heard at a Christian school, what one? All. You heard that C.S. Lewis was a Christian, right? Okay, first of all, Christian Accelerated School has, what I'm about to tell you, have investigated what I said, Christian Accelerated Education, and because of it, are now ordering all their schools to ban Lewis's work. They checked into it very carefully. So did my pastor, because he was getting hit very hard with it. Found everything I said to be true. When a witch is ready to be initiated, she must not just read, but she must study the complete work of Lewis, fictional work. Lewis has said that the way to God is like a hallway with many doors. They all lead to it. Okay? Now, the fictional works of Lewis are very real to witches. They're not fictional, they're history to witches. They really believe them. Okay? They believe their guidelines. Now, Lewis was a member of the Golden Dawn. Now, that's been proven. along with a fellow brother of the same coven named Tolkien, who wrote The Hobbit. They were in the same time. Now, the Golden Dawn is the private church that the Rothschilds must pick every member of that church personally. It's in London. The oldest coven in the world. Okay? That's Lewis. Whether he says he's a Christian or not, that doesn't mean anything. That's what Christians are making a terrible mistake.
Could it be that he was like that, and like yourself, he got converted, and now he's no longer that?
He would have had to tell it. But Lewis' name was on the Golden Dawn records right up to the time that I got out. I mean, there's no betrayal there. He never did leave them. Okay? I want to say something real quick that will answer this. Many people supposedly are getting saved from the Manson family and from other things. Let me tell you something real quick so there will be no misunderstanding. You come out of the occult, you come out of the Masons, you come out anything of the Illuminati, it's one distinct thing. Anywhere there's a vow of secrecy, that vow of secrecy must... be broken. Not in part, please. When somebody breaks their complete vow of secrecy, they're out. But until they do, they're not... Okay?
Charlene, this is it.
That's right.
Men and double what?
Witness language. That's exactly right. Okay.
Did you hear his question? How do Masons relate to all of this?
Okay.
Listen closely, you Masons.
Council 13 is the highest council of the Illuminati. The council right below it is the Council of 33. That's called the Grand Masters. There are the 33 highest Masons in the world. To be a member of the Council of 33, you must take a human life in a ceremony to prove you're worthy. We have in our hands copies. The Chip Publications is releasing this in their new book, Angel of Light. Copies of a 32nd, 33rd level book, which proclaims Jesus Christ, the God of brutality and sin and evil, and Lucifer, the God of love, beauty, and peace, and the true God. Yeah, a little shocking, huh? Different from what I portrayed. But don't be mad at the lower Masons. It also says in the same book that the lower Masons are sheep to be sheared. Now, many Masons are getting saved through our message, lower and higher, because they recognize when I, and I didn't tonight, gave my initiation to become a witch, and my vow of secrecy is the same as theirs, all the way through, the same, no different. Now, Masons were started by the Illuminati. It's all through our history that they're tied with the Illuminati. Their rites are witchcraft rites when witchcraft had to go underground. We've had people come in and tear up their membership cards and get right with the Lord. Mainly because if you didn't know that Charles Finney was a Mason, and when he got saved, he said, I can't be a Mason and be a Christian. It is impossible because the vows I must take are non-Christian vows. Okay? People are getting saved right and left, and they all have one thing to say. When they leave the Masons, the reason they didn't leave before is they were afraid of what the Masons would do to them. Now, if it is a good group, why are people afraid to leave it?